Father, the creator of the heavens and the earth, the one who led his son to the slaughter, the one who was willing to kill his only beloved this day for our lives. We say to my God, to God be the glory, great things you have done. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Great is our God and greatly to be praised. You are worthy of the highest praise. All honor, all glory, all power, all praise be unto thee, O Ancient of Days, and unto the Lamb of God forever. We bless the holy name of the Sovereign Lord, King, and Master, the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We uphold his name. We extol his name. We give you glory that is due to you. Hallelujah. Hosanna to the King of Kings. Hosanna to the Lord of Lords. Hosanna to the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Hosanna to the fairer than 10,000. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless you, my Lord. We exalt you. We exalt you. We exalt you for all that you have done. We exalt you for all that you're doing. We exalt you for all that you're going to do. Hosanna to him. Somebody give him praise. We bless the Lord. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. In this Passover week, we dedicate every praise to you. As we gather here tonight, we gather because we love you and we want to honor you. And somebody just give him thanks this day for all that is done. We bless you, we bless you, we bless you this day. And so with the blood that's never lost its power, I sanctify this place. I declare this altar holy unto our God. I declare this pulpit holy unto our God. And I pray, arise from your rest and be blessed today. Awaken from your habitation and be enthroned in the praises of your people. Father, tonight I pray a release of the spirit of worship, of the spirit of praise in the household of the Lord. We honor you and we give you glory. Father, thank you for the anointing. Lead us by the Holy Spirit. Bless this team as they will minister unto you today, Lord. Receive our thanksgiving. Anoint your servant as he will minister today. May the Spirit of the Lord God be upon him. Bless us, Father, that the word will bring edification, ministry, and strength this day. We glorify you now as we continue in Jesus' mighty name. Give the Lord a praise as we go to worship. Tonight, I want you to give him the highest praise. I want you to know he was denied for you. I want you to know he loves you. I want you to know it was all about you. It was all about you. Hallelujah. Let us bless the Lord. Father, we worship you. We glorify you. Father, we know tonight you're going to manifest yourself. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody just raise your hands. We worship you, Lord. Yahweh Rapha.
Glory.
on, sing.
Yahweh, Rapha, Elohim, Shaddai, Jireh, Adonai, who manifest himself.
Sing Yahweh. Sing your glory,
your glory, tangible in this place.
Lord, you do it.
Lord, you do it something great.
Waking,
waking supernatural.
Sing Yahweh. Somebody worship the Lord. Just raise your hands and glorify him.
He will manifest himself.
If you call him, he will manifest himself.
And if you seek him,
he will manifest himself.
Yeah.
Sing.
And if you worship, he will manifest himself. And if you call him, he will manifest himself.
If you seek him,
he will manifest himself. He will manifest himself. And if you call him, he will manifest himself. And if you seek him, he will manifest himself.
Yeah. Yahweh.
Yahweh
will manifest himself. Jireh will manifest himself. Rapha will manifest himself. Will manifest himself.
Yahweh
will manifest himself.
Himself.
Rapha will manifest himself.
manifest himself, will manifest himself.
Sing Yahweh.
Yahweh.
raise your hand and sing praise. Speaking to me crazy these last few weeks, and I've been having dreams and visions and dreams and visions, and some of those dreams and visions are going to come true very quickly for this house. So I had a dream of ministering with a man of God tonight, and I saw this man of God 70 years of age, and I was ministering with him. So I picked up the phone and I phoned him. I said, man of God, will you minister with me on this Tuesday night? And he said no. And I went to bed the next day and I had the dreams and visions. And I found this man of God. I said, man of God, the Lord said you're going to minister with me. And he said, prophet, I'm not ready yet. Then I had dreams and visions again the third night. And I found the man of God. He says, what is your pastor going to say? I said, don't worry about that. I'm always in trouble. Then I knew it was of God because he said to me, he's not going to charge me to minister tonight. But if the finance team want to bless him, he normally charges $10,000 a session. So feel free to bless him. So let's just pray over the word as the man of God comes up to minister with me tonight. Father God, we thank you for the word. We thank you for this pulpit we declare is holy. We thank you, Lord, that your people's ears are ready to position themselves for the man of God and ourselves as we minister tonight. Father, this is a dream. This is a vision over this house. And today we set into place what you have shown the prophet, Father. I declare you have given me authority with this man of God to preach the gospel of God tonight. You have given us authority to move strongholds tonight. You have given us authority to shift things in the spiritual realm. And there'll be a repositioning tonight of everyone that has come here tonight. And we give you the glory and the honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Good evening. Welcome to Christ Kingdom Ministry, where anything can happen. Amen. You may have your seats this morning, this evening. I want to give you a quick story very quickly. Thank you, worship team. I'm sorry I messed you up there. John 5. And we're preaching tonight. This is the Holy Ghost. And I know we're going to flow. We're preaching about positioning yourself for your breakthrough. The problem in this house is you're hearing so many things happen, but you haven't positioned yourself. So in John chapter 5, verse 1 to 8, there was a man, and you know the story, sitting at a well. And this man sat at the well. They said he had an infirmity for 38 years. I don't believe he sat there for 38 years, to be technical tonight, but I believe he had an infirmity for 38 years. And in the 38 years, it seemed that no one picked him up and put him into the well that the angel stirred up. You see, for too long we're waiting for somebody to pick us up. In this house, Christ Kingdom Ministries, its partners that are watching. And you know when the guys come for prayer in front, and Minister Rowan will see that tonight, when you pray for somebody, they'll give you all the excuses in the world. This man said to Jesus, you know, no one picked me up. No one saw me. No one helped me. But Jesus didn't care about all the excuses. He said, just get up. Today, maybe the Lord is not waiting for somebody to pick you up. Maybe he's waiting for you to lift yourself up and position yourself for your breakthrough. For there's got to be a change in your mindset for this breakthrough. There's got to be a shift in your mindset for this breakthrough. Because I know that 38 years wasn't much waiting there. Some of you are waiting more than that. It may seem a long time for you. But if we change our mindset tonight and position ourselves correctly, God is about to shift you. Man of God, I know you know people over 38 years. Go for it.
I greet you all in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ. I never thought I'd be standing here. But through the grace and the power of Jesus Christ and
his blood,
Prof told me that this is the topic he wanted to speak on, and it was a day or two before that I was watching sermons and I was studying a bit, and this, it already came to me beforehand, and this is exactly ties in with what he wanted to speak on. So one of the things when we talk about positioning ourselves for breakthrough, which comes to mind, one of the greatest hindrances that we have is bringing our mindset into alignment. Our minds are the greatest hindrance to us receiving our breakthrough. What is a mindset? It is a collection of beliefs and thoughts that make up a mental attitude, a pattern of thinking. One of our greatest hindrances is definitely to God's blessings is the hindrance is the mindset. Proverbs 23 verse 7, as a man thinks in his heart, so is he. You cannot always control the circumstances, but you can certainly control your thoughts. You know, nothing changes in your mind. Nothing changes until your mind changes. You know, there was a great author who wrote one of the best-selling self-help books, Napoleon Hill. He says, we are the sum total of our thoughts. The only limitations we have are those set up in our minds. It's also said, we in the construction industry, says, we thought we do difficult projects, but it says one of the most difficult projects in the world is the reconstruction of the human mind. In fact, they say it is easier to go to Mars than to change a person's mindset. Now, where in the Bible do we see this happening more substantially than the children of Israel? When God led them out of Egypt. Listen, if you read from Exodus 14 verse 12, this was when the Israelites were standing by Moses. They were complaining to Moses. They said, did we not say to you in Egypt, leave us alone. Let us serve the Egyptians, for it would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians as slaves than to die in the wilderness. Now, this is after all the miracles have happened. The father, they were led out of Egypt. They were given gold. The Lord appeared to them as a cloud of pillar by day and a pillar of fire by night. Yet they saw all of this, yet they still murmured. Now, do you see the problem of a mindset? And it's also, as I wrote here, the problem with the Israelites was the 400 years, plus years, of slavery created a slave mentality in them. It was easier for God to deliver the Israelites from oppression than to deliver them out of their mindset. This is why now we wonder why God took them in the wilderness and made them wander for 40 years. Every day, you know, God must have really considered the mindset such a problem of the Israelites that he made them wander for 40 years. You know what's an amazing thing? If you look at the distance from Israel to Egypt, the walking distance will only take you 30 days. Yet, they wandered for 40 years. So the Bible, if you read in Exodus, the Bible says that the Lord took them not through the way of the Philistines, where they would have to face war, but they took them the long route, where they had to wander for 40 years. And why they didn't take them through the way of the Philistines? Because they would have had to fight. And if the Israelites saw that, they would want to go back to Egypt. Mentality.
Amen. You see, your mentality dictates where you are going to be in the season. There's a few things that are going to happen so quick and swiftly, it's going to blow your mind. 2025 is happening. Land is being acquired. It's going to shift so quickly, it's going to blow your mind tonight as we come together in agreement. Two people touching anything in agreement. We touch this pulpit in agreement, and we're going to shift your mindset. A 30-year journey, a 38-year standing at the well, 40 years of the Israelites. There has got to be a shift in the mindset of this house for you to get your breakthrough. How can a person come yesterday and get their breakthrough? And you're walking with Pastor for 17 years. And Prophet, I'm walking for 21 years. And I'm walking for 30 years. How can I have a vision of a man preaching a message that I haven't heard yet? We haven't rehearsed. But the Lord said, I'm putting things together so quick in this church that the sons will overtake the fathers. That the miracles you saw the fathers doing, the sons will do greater. I'm shifting your mindset tonight. And amen. And as a mindset shifts, your miracle is here. If you are here tonight and you decided to be here tonight, you're going to get your miracle tonight. In Jesus' name.
And I'm just going to carry on about the Israelites. I want to say, is it safe to say that even when we see miracles, or even when we experience miracles, that will not even change your mindset? For the Israelites, even in the 40 years, every day they saw a miracle. Why? They ate manna from heaven. They drank water for free out of a rock. Their clothes and their sandals never wore out for 40 years. Now, miracles happen every day, yet they still, God made them wander for 40 years because the mindsets of the people never changed. You see, no matter what God promises you, if your mind cannot handle it, you will never get it. Your mentality determines the fulfillment of God's promises in your life. 2 Kings 20 verse 1, it says, set your house in order. We pray for many things. We want our business to grow, but can you handle it? Are we prepared to handle the growth? Not changing our mentality is like praying for rain. We pray to God for rain all the time. Lord, send us rain. The Father says, yes, my children, I can send you rain anytime. But he says, if I send you the rain today, if it rains today, tomorrow the sun will dry it up. He says, why have you not dug wells? Why have you not prepared? Why haven't you positioned yourself to receive the rain? Because even if I send it, you can't hold it. Israel accepted the external conditioning as their internal destiny. The way it was on the outside was the way it was on the inside. Family, we need to break the strongholds of our minds, our attitudes, and our mindsets. Romans 12, verse 2. Be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of the mind. And how do we renew our mind? Is through the Word of God. 2 Corinthians 10, verse 5. We demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God. And we take every thought to make it obedient to Christ. Proverbs 4 verse 23, guard your heart and mind above all. Now Solomon, one of the wisest people, wrote this. He says, above all, guard your heart and mind, else for it determines the course of your life. In conclusion of my points, as I'm saying, allowing God's word to change the way we think and act is the first step to believing in him to do the impossible. Negativity and doubt cannot survive in the light of his truth. God has already prepared the blessing and the breakthrough for you. But are we prepared for the breakthrough?
Tonight we're preparing your mind for something that's about to happen in this house. When you sing two ministers, I know you're a little bit confused. But the Lord is saying, I'm preparing you for things that are coming. I'm preparing you to shift into a place like the Israelites were murmuring. You see, when you saw this building going up, you're murmuring, how is the pastor going to do and make a building out of that bottle stone? And then the building went up. Then you were murmuring, oh, some rain came down the stairs. You had to push the rain up. But the rain got taken away and carpets came here. And now you're murmuring, oh, where am I going to park my car now because the church is built and I have to park so far away. But we're acquiring the land around the church. What is there to murmur about anymore? The Lord is saying, stop your murmuring. Stop being like the children of Israelite. We want a 24-hour. We put a demand on the anointing tonight that a 24-hour miracle is about to happen because you are going to shift your mindset tonight. You're not going to be like the children of Israel. I need somebody like the lady with the issue of blood that's going to push in. You say, I don't care. I don't, you know what's significant about tonight? The Holy Ghost is telling me now what's significant about tonight. This is the first time you're hearing Minister Rowan minister. Tonight, according to the Holy Week, Palm Sunday he rode. But on Monday and Tuesday was the first time Jesus spoke in the synagogue. So something has to happen. I didn't know that until now. The Holy Spirit just reminded me now. I'm telling you something is about to happen to shift your mindset, because I'm telling you right now that tonight the Lord's about to open the floodgates of heaven. I need somebody who had that issue to push in. It doesn't matter who's in front. They're going to push in. They're going to push around just to grab that anointing tonight. For the Lord your God is about to break through. You are not going to wonder anymore. You'll stop your wondering tonight. You're going to push in. You're going to receive. You're going to get your breakthrough. I am not waiting for the month to end. I'm waiting for this last Tuesday of the month for a breakthrough to come that you haven't seen, for a breakthrough to come that you haven't heard of, for the breakthrough to change your mindset. Things are going. Listen, you cannot miss a meeting. If you're watching at home, you cannot miss a meeting in this house, because you don't know when the angel of the Lord is about to stir the water in the house. And tonight we're invoking that stirring tonight. We're causing the shifting in the atmosphere tonight. Just prophesy into the man of God. We're causing a shift in the atmosphere tonight. A change in your mindset tonight. Amen. Amen. So we've got to speak into the atmosphere and shift your mindset.
In Ecclesiastes 3, it says, to everything there is a season and a time, to every purpose Amen. Under heaven. As surely as there's summer and winter, surely as there's rain and wind, surely as the seasons change, your season has to change. It cannot stay the same forever. As the Lord says, a time for everything, and we declare and we prophesy that this is our season where it begins to change. And the Lord, we shall meditate on His word day and night, and we shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of the water that shall bring forth fruit in our season. Our leaf shall never wither, and everything we do shall prosper.
Amen. So I prophesy to you that this is your day, and this is your time, and your season for your miracle. I take the word of the man of God, and I say, and I come into agreement, and I touch the things of heaven. I say that child that's wayward is coming together tonight. Wherever he's sitting, that husband is leaving the bottle tonight. That autistic child is coming right tonight. There's healing in your house, even as you were here at 7:33 tonight. When there's healing in your house, and your wife is going to tell you, something happened at home. What did Pastor Anil do in the church? Something happened at home. Things are happening in your household right now. This is your season for a breakthrough. The Lord is about to shift your seasoning. You see, you need to be in Luke. We talk about Luke 19, verse 1 to 5. There was a short man called Zechariah. He heard that the Lord was coming, and he couldn't reach and he couldn't see past the people. How many of you have heard of miracles in the house, and you couldn't push past the people? Tonight, I need you to push in to get your miracle. There's a lady here that came to us last week, Tuesday, and I said, tell Pastor Anil. She said in 2022, we prayed for her that she'll have a house. Now, for you that don't believe in testimony, Revelation says you'll overcome the devil, you'll overcome Satan by the blood of the Lamb and the word of your testimony. So this lady came back and she said, you'll prophesy that I'll have a house, I'll have a white house. It'll be a double story, and from my balcony when I'm having my tea, I'll look past the branches and I'll see the ocean. So I said, okay. She said, but prophet, we got the house. Then the guy took us up to the balcony, and he said, can you see the trees? I said, no, the trees are lovely. He said, no, look in between the trees. You'll see the ocean. But she said, but I was concerned because I had a prophetic word that was specific. It said it'll be a white house. So we Googled the house and went back to 2022 on Google Earth, and the house was white. God will not make a mistake with you tonight. He will set your feet like deer, and you will not be moved like the tree planted by the water.
See, family of God, we were created as kings upon this earth.
Amen.
The earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. But the Psalms 115 verse 6, I'll read to you. The heaven, even the heavens are the Lord's, but the earth He gave to the children of men. That means we are kings. We can decree things and we can prophesy things on the earth. We shall lack no good thing. What is it lacking in your life? Healing. We can call it forth on the earth because we are the kings. The Lord gave us as kings, but He is the King of kings. We should not be as slaves. Do not have the slave mentality. You are enthroned. Your kingdom and your kingship comes from the Lord God Almighty. Therefore, we ask and we declare that every breakthrough shall come to pass.
We declare that you are kings in the kingdom of God. I need you to get that mindset. I'm not worried about your bank account now. I don't care you have to push the car or take a taxi. You're a king in the kingdom of God. And if you change your mindset to believe the word of God tonight, He's about to press a reset button over you. He's about to position you instead and despite your mindset. He's about to move you out of sickness. He's about to move you out of poverty. He's about to shift you into ministry. He's about to cause you to make an impact on this earth. You are an earth shaker. You will shake the foundation of the earth. You're a history maker. Your name will go down. This church, 2025, they made history. You're a history maker. The Lord is about to shift that mindset. And I'm talking to you, if you really need a miracle, this is a good time to run to the front. I'm declaring over you tonight. What's going to happen is Minister Rowan and I, we're going to anoint you while the pastors pray in a minute or so. But I'm declaring over you tonight that if you require your miracle and your mindset is right, and your mindset is right, just change their mindsets, brother. Just change their mindset. Pray over the mindsets. Because when you lay hands, be ready to receive.
Our Father in heaven, we give you all the praise and all the honor. We declare that you are the Almighty God, the Creator of the heavens and the earth. For the Lord spoke and it was. For he commanded and the earth stood still. My God, I give you the praise and I give you the honor. Jesus, I declare your name is above every other name. There is none like you, O God. We thank you, O Lord, for your blood. We thank you, O Lord, that your blood conquers all.
Yes.
Your blood breaks every chain and every stronghold. Right now, Lord, I declare your blood upon every mind this day.
Yes.
Every stronghold of the mind, O Lord, that has been created
set
in the
free,
people
free,
from their
free,
own doing or from
free,
the past or from the,
free,
where they grew up,
free,
O Lord. You are able to do the exceedingly abundantly above all we can ask, Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus that you break every chain of the mind, O Lord. Every stronghold of the mind, in the name of Jesus, I declare you are broken. I rebuke you, you spirit that comes to hinder the mindsets of the people. You will not be like the children of Israel. I declare you will not wander for 40 years, but the Lord will accelerate you in his time. For the season is now, says the Lord God Almighty. I will bless my people. For he says, prepare yourself. Prepare your mind in the name of Jesus. Draw nigh unto me and I will draw nigh unto you, says the Lord God Almighty. I am with thee. I am with thee. I am Emmanuel. I am your God. I am the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I have led the people out and I will lead you, my people. I will lead you to the promised land if you will only seek me. He says, seek me first and I will give you all these things, said the Lord God Almighty. And I declare and I thank you, O God. I thank you for the breakthrough. I thank you for your blood, O God. I thank you for every life that is here, oh God. You have created us for purpose. You have created a destiny. You created us to prosper. You've given us plans to prosper and never to harm us. I declare and I prophesy that now, that every destiny and every promise, every purpose that God has placed in you, that it will come and make itself manifest in the season over your life. I declare in the mighty name of Jesus.
I break every diabolical spirit tonight. Every spirit of depression leaves this territory. Everything that came to hinder the service leaves. I shut up everything of the flesh now. Every thought that you have of the flesh, we shut it down. It is your night for a breakthrough. Lord, we stir up the waters. We stir up the waters. We stir up the waters in this house. We bring down. We open up the heavens. We declare and decree. Strongholds in the mind have been broken as the man of God prayed. We declare and decree. Every Satan, get your hands off God's property tonight. There's no more depression. There's no more suicide. There's no more irritation. We decree over you right now that the anointing will break the yoke tonight. And even as you hear, and even as you feel, and even as you touch, and even as you see hands being laid on you, expect your miracle to be met. For the Lord said he's going to meet you tonight. He's going to shift you tonight. Amen. So stay in that attitude of prayer. Can I get the worship team up here? Stay in that attitude of prayer. The Lord's about to break something tonight. He's about to break something tonight. Father, you shift your people tonight. You shift your people tonight. Oh, we give you glory. 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 We give you praise in this house. We give you praise in this house. Oh, we magnify. We're going to be laying hands just now. We're just waiting for the atmosphere. We magnify your name. We magnify your name. We glorify your name. We glorify. We lift, we lift, we lift. We lift you up today, Father. We lift you up today, Father. Father, we praise you. There is nothing that you will withhold from your children tonight. There's nothing that you will withhold from your children tonight. Father, this vision didn't come just by chance. You're about to shift mindsets. You're about to change the atmosphere. All honor, all glory unto you today, Father. Oh, we give you praise. We give you praise. We give you praise. Just stay in that attitude of prayer. I want you to stand for your blessing. That just keep it in mind as we come and lay hands on you. For the Lord's about to move. He's about to shift you. The devil's going to lose. He's going to lose your DNA. He's going to lose the scent of you. You're going to be bathed by water tonight. There'll be a water shift. There'll be anointing oil flowing. There'll be fire, fire, fire. Shut up. Shut up in your bones tonight. Oh, we glorify you. We glorify you. We glorify you. We praise your name. We praise your name.
Hallelujah.
We praise your name. You don't need to sing. Just take in the music. Just take in the worship. Just take in the worship. Let the praise and worship just sing over you. Just take in the worship.
You deserve the glory.
Oh, you deserve glory tonight, Father.
And the honor.
Yes.
Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. You are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. You are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. Your holy name, you deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. You are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. You are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. You are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you.
Surrender all. to Him.
Thank you.
Is there somebody we didn't pray over? Has everybody been prayed over? Amen. I'd like, under this anointing, Pastor, I need just to stand in front of this pulpit facing you. And all the pastors to form a ring and hold each other's hand and hold his hands as we form a ring here. Would you please raise your hand toward the men of God in this house? Raise your hand toward the men of God in this house, for they are in charge of your well-being. They're in charge of whether you make it to heaven or hell.
Has never lost this power, Lord. And every spirit right now, I declare in the name of Jesus, that exalts itself above the name of Jesus Christ, I come against you in the name of Jesus. And I declare you have no power here. You have no power, and I break every plan of the enemy that has come to separate, that has come to destroy this church, that has come to to backbite and stop the destiny and the growth and the purpose and the vision being accomplished of the Lord God Almighty, I come against you through the blood of Jesus Christ, and I declare you are rendered powerless now in the name of Jesus. But Lord, I seal them. I seal this pastoral team with the blood of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, you will work. You will bind them with cords that can never be broken, oh God. Let everything from the wall of fire around them, let everything from out there, every dart, every fiery arrow, every destruction that comes, I declare that the Spirit of God will raise up a standard. I declare the enemy shall come in one way and the Lord will scatter them seven ways. They have no power, for the Lord God Almighty is before you. Who can be against you? Lift up ye head, all ye gates, and be ye lifted up, all ye everlasting doors, that the King of glory may come in. And who is this King of glory? He is the Lord God strong and mighty. He is the same God yesterday. He's the same God today and forevermore. And he's the same God over you. He's the same God that led the Israelites out of the desert. He's the same God that protected them all the years, 40 years. I declare he's the same God that will now protect you and be with you. I declare that in the name of Jesus. And every mindset of God, and every mindset and every stronghold of the enemy that comes against this mindset, every pattern and thinking that is contrary to the will of God in this pastor, I declare and I render you powerless. But in this season, oh God, you will accelerate them. You will accelerate them to achieve that which you have destined, oh God. That which you have set forth, oh God, from the foundation of the earth. You saw this place. You saw this ministry. And, oh Lord, nothing shall come against your vision, oh God. And I declare now, oh Lord, we honor you and I thank you, oh Lord. I thank you for a time such as this, oh God. A time to favor Zion. Yea, oh God, the set time has come. And I plead the blood. Lord, Holy Spirit, I plead that you seal everything in the name of Jesus Christ. This team, which this pastoral team will never be the same, oh God. You will position them again. Position them, oh God, to receive, not only a breakthrough, but position themselves to accomplish the vision that you have set forth for this ministry, oh God. Whatever the Lord, Jesus, I honor you. I glorify your name. I declare your name is above all. I just want to thank you, oh God, for that which you have, what you have started a work, oh God. You shall accomplish. You shall finish, oh God. And I honor you now, my Father. I thank you for all that you have done and what you are going to do. And I ask this all in Jesus' name.
Amen, amen. Praise God, praise God.
Come on, give the Lord the glory. That's it. I waited for many years for my son to stand in. I had personal chats with him as a father. And I told him there's an anointing for you to preach the word. And I told him to come. And he said, Dad, he's still studying. And thank you, Prophet Life. Yo, this man is on fire. It makes me again understand something. How the enemy tries to hold you back. And so raise your hand. As God has released my son, I prophesy release on everyone. Today was a mind shift change. So do you believe in the word of the prophet? Do you believe in the word of the prophet? Therefore receive the word of the prophet for 2024. I prophesy an open door for your opportunities. I prophesy an open door for your miracles. I prophesy an open door for your release of every grace upon your life, upon your family. I prophesy you will be the head and not the tail. I prophesy this day that you will be strong and mighty and fulfill your purpose upon the earth. I prophesy open doors for financial breakthrough. I prophesy open doors for debt cancellation. I prophesy the anointing of God will manifest. Yahweh will manifest. Jesus will manifest. The Holy Ghost will manifest. I prophesy every chain that limits you into an open door of breakthrough will be broken. I prophesy tonight be a breakthrough. Tonight be your breakthrough. Tonight be set free. Tonight every grace be set free. Tonight every purpose be set free in Jesus' name. Give the Lord a praise, somebody. I think he deserves another praise, somebody. Glory! Hallelujah! Wow! Just one more praise for him. Just one more praise. Amen. You may take your seat for a moment. Thank you for that praise. Because we remember that walk this week for our breakthrough. It was all for our breakthrough. Hallelujah. Beloved, well, you know what's happening this weekend? Friday is the Passover weekend. Passover week or Passover Friday. We celebrate at this house at 8:30. Invite your family, friends, loved ones, neighbors. Let them receive the greatest miracle of all. The gift of salvation. The one Messiah dying. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. That's the greatest gift you can give somebody. Bring them to here and let us come early at 8:30. Come prepared. And on that, one of you to give him the highest. Beloved, he opened not his mouth. Led like a lamb to the slaughter. You know why? He saw my face and he saw your face. Can I hear amen, somebody? And Sunday, likewise, what an awesome day of celebration. The resurrection of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. He's alive. Amen. And it's also at 8:30. Invite family and friends and loved ones, workmates. Let them come, because I really believe there will be an open heaven. I really believe, you know, when you celebrate the Lord's table, in both the meetings, the presence of God is there. So we want to see you dressed up. We want to see you worshiping the best, and come early. So we got a date this weekend. Wednesday, there's still Bible school at 6:30. Intercession on Thursday at 9 a.m. Friday, okay, we ministered. No youth meeting on Friday, but deliverance meeting on Saturday at 12 o'clock. Oh, that's canceled. Okay. Also, believe Pastor Stanley is not well. Can we just, while you remain seated, or just raise your hand. Father, I release. You said, Lord, I sent forth your word. Your word healed his disease now. In the mighty name of Jesus, I bring the servant of God, Stanley, Pastor Stanley, before you. And Father, I rebuke every infirmity in the mighty name of Jesus. And I declare by the stripes of Jesus, servant of God, be healed. By the stripes of Jesus, be healed. Be made whole. Be strengthened now. I speak full recovery now in the mighty name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, for full recovery. And I give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Everybody stand. Hallelujah. 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 Call Pastor Prophet Amos. I'm going to bless and release you. Everybody raise your hand. Hallelujah. How many of you didn't come to the front for prayer? Raise your hand. Anyone? Everyone came? Who didn't come to the front? Come, please. Come, 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 come. Everyone who hasn't come, don't miss your opportunity. I'm delaying the meeting for you. I don't want no one to miss a breakthrough. Hallelujah. I'm going to call Rowan and Prophet while I give you a minute. Two minutes, 3 minutes, that's fine. Beloved, we're done. Is that okay? A few minutes? How about let's just worshiping the Lord in the meantime? Hallelujah. This is what
This is what the Passover is about. God so loved that he wanted everyone to receive the blessing. None of the sons and daughters going without a blessing today. Hallelujah. So we don't forget baptism on the Passover Sunday. That's this Sunday after the morning service. Please take my offer. I mean it all my heart. If you have neighbors, family and friends, whether they're bound with drugs, bound with things, they've never get baptized, but they've come through a Christian faith and something happened. This pastor wants to baptize them. Is that all right? I want to baptize anyone who's not, who hasn't been baptized or never been fully immersed. Okay? Maybe you haven't been to the class tonight, but you will come on Sunday ready. For the ladies, you can wear a shorts, come with your overdress or whatever, shorts underneath, with a towel. Men, you can have your shorts and shirt and have something to change with and come with a towel. That's all you need. I will lead you in the water of baptism. How awesome is that? How many wants to join me that's never been? Anyone wants to join us on Sunday? Raise your hand. Is it? No takers here. No one. You'll all been baptized. You'll all know if you die, you're not baptized, you may not make it to heaven. So let's just get it. Hallelujah. And so, my Father, I thank you for the service tonight. We thank you for an awesome time of impartation. We thank you for the stirring of gifts. We just thank you to be in your presence. And again tonight, we want to thank you, Jesus, for the price that you paid. We remember this week and how everything led to your sacrifice and your crucifixion. We want to give you praise. And so today, raise your hand.
May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May he cause his face to shine on you. May you be delivered from any arrow of darkness, discouragement, depression,